So the last step is now pretty simple. So C is coding. So now we've got our variable xq of n. So this means, so we've got samples, and that's quantified. So that we have given it some index numbers. So, and this we just turn into a binary sequence now. Or more specifically into a data type. Classical data types are, for example, integer. And they are integer with 8-bit, 16 bits, or 32 bits are quite popular for audio. And so with these integers, sometimes also floating point is used, but very often it is usually integer. So let's have a look at an example file. And as an example, we use audio. So audio just means we have some kind of microphone, and we send this analog signal here into an AD converter, and then at the output here, we are getting our samples here. So just numbers: 22, 8, minus 7, minus 30, and so on. So these are our samples here. And what we talked about with the ABC points we had there before, so we need to define a sampling rate. So in audio, these classical sampling rates are 48 kilohertz is the highest, usually 44.1 kilohertz or even 8 kilohertz. So the incoming signal here, so if we have something like this, then it's sampled at this frequency here. So if this is here our interval here, so let's call this here TS, then the sampling rate is 1 over FS. So that's our sampling rate. Okay, that's a bit squeezed in there, but you will see that here. So therefore these are our samples, and then this gives us our sampling rate here. Okay, so then the other thing is what we talked about was the quantization. So the quantization is usually done in 8-bit. So this gives us 256 levels, or 16-bit, or for very high quality audio, 24-bits. So usually sound recording or in professional editing, 24-bits are used, 16-bit is for standard consumer electronics or consumer DVDs, or and then the 8-bit is just for simple Windows sound effects or something like that. And then obviously this is turned into data types. And then all these here, they're just encoded as integer, just in different precisions. So the 8-bit, you could call this also unsigned. Unsigned character. So that's this one here, and then the other two here, they're integer. Integer characters, so integer types. So that's here integer. And the 8-bit here, that's an unsigned character. Okay, so let's just have a look at an audio file I've recorded a while, so let's get here the spider environment up here. Here we go. So let's just load this WAV file into Python here. So I've prepared a WAV file called apple.wav. So in order to load this, we need to import SciPy. And there's a subfolder inside called IO, and then there's a subfolder, or there's a module called WAV file. And I import this as a WAV file. Okay, so that's imported. And now I can use the read function of WAV file to load this apple.wav. And the read function returns a tuple. We can check that here, or not print, check this here, help. If we do WAV file dot read, so we see here what this function is able to read. So it returns the sampling rate of the WAV file, and then the second part of the tuple is a data. So the data is read from the WAV file. So the actual types, what this read function supports is 8-bit PCM, so 8-bit resolution, minimum 0, maximum 255, you see, and then 16-bit PCM, so that's from minus 32768 to 32767, so that's an integer 16. Let's remember, that's our data type here. So I've been talking about, so we've got here 16-bit integer, and so Python calls this here an int 16, and then 32-bit PCM, so that's an int 32, and is also able to load floating point numbers as a data format. So that's float 32. Okay, so as we say here, so the read command gives us this tuple back, and so let's just do this. So if we have fs comma data equals to WAV file dot read, and as I said, that's called apple dot WAV. Okay, so it's loaded, no error messages. So let's have a look what fs tells us. So that's a sampling rate of 48 kilohertz. So we could write something like this here, print sampling rate is comma fs, to have it nicely written down here. Okay, so let's have a look at the data, and we see here and that's the start of the data samples here. And at the end of this, D type is 16 in 16. So this means here, I'm looking at the help screen here. So that's this one here, which is inside. So the values ranging. So that's the minimum value here of our data set, the theoretical minimum value and the theoretical positive value. And so now let's just have a look at a bit more of the data here. So in Python won't show you more than this glimpse of the array here. So for that reason, I just write a for loop for I in data. So I just iterate through the data and print the values here on the screen. Yeah. So we see here loads of values from this audio sample showing up here. Here we see a couple of higher ones. And so let's just check what the maximum value of our samples is. Yeah, so that's 23,029. So that's pretty close to the maximum theoretical value. And then let's have a look at the minimum value. So that's also pretty close to the maximum theoretical one. Remember here when we're going back to the help function here, these were our theoretical values here. and these are the actual values. Obviously, the audio will never, or hopefully never, reach these maximum values, because above that, the converter wouldn't have been able to convert this and would just clip. Okay, so that's a simple example how analog data has been quantized. So in this case, it was audio.